YouTube, welcome to Cafe You Know Man. Welcome to our reaction to Lee and Womack. We are going to react to the song There Is a God.
Yes. Yeah.
Now, this is requested by our patron Warren. I'm looking forward to it. There Is a God. Let's find out what the song is.
Yeah, about. Thank you for enlightening me about the fact that there is a God. Yes. Yeah, looking forward to listen to it for the first time. Yes. Lee and Womack.
Your arms around a 100-year-old tree. Climb up on a horse and let him run full speed. Take a look down at the world from 30,000 feet on your next flight. Watch a flock of birds against the morning sun. Close your eyes and listen to the river run. Catch a firefly in your hand or a raindrop on your tongue. That's right. There is in a few years, hear him laughing. Don't it sound like a sign? Stop and think about what you don't understand. Things like life and love and how the world began. Hear a doctor say you can't explain it, but the cancer's gone.
Connections initially with some of the things that were mentioned, what had that to do with the presence of God?
Mm-hmm.
But I'm assuming this artist is from the US of A.
Mm-hmm.
In that part of the world, any little thing could perhaps make you believe that there is a God, because So many people have become anti-God in that part of the world. Or even if they do believe, they do not believe enough. So yeah, I mean, any little thing will do for them. So I guess the connections make more sense to them than they did to me. Yeah, I like that baby reference and the cancer's gone. So yeah, there is a God. But apart from that, I really couldn't see anything that was that deep that and made sense or was meaningful. The raindrop and the firefly on your tongue, I mean, that was silly. That was downright silly. Whoever thought of that was quite silly in putting those two together. Yeah, I mean, there's nothing to do with God. Yeah, God, yes, just take a look around, like it was said later. It was like the songwriter matured up a bit towards the end of the song herself or himself, depending who wrote it.
Mm-hmm.
Then take a look around. I mean, you take a look around you, depending where you're living, of course. But I take a look around outside my window, inside my home, my wife, the kids, everything that I have in my life, the outside the window, the sounds of the birds, the neighbors upstairs. Yeah, I mean, there is a God, I guess. And God is watching and God is giving and God is being grateful.
Mm-hmm.
And I am grateful, if that makes sense.
Okay. For me, it wasn't that difficult to understand. There is a God. I say there are all gods, everywhere gods, because of the Indian culture. For us, God is omnipresent. So yeah, there is a God everywhere. Everywhere there is
millions of gods.
Yeah, millions. 330 million. That,
ah.
330. Yeah.
330. So every American is a god.
Could be, that could be the population when people came up with this number, that there are perhaps 330 million gods. Everybody is a god. Everything is God. Every creation of God is God himself. He is in there, in every bit of this planet. And when she said the tree, the sky, the birds, the sun, everything, everything. So for us, yeah, we worship everybody as God, as long as it's all nature and it's creation. Work of creation, not our guns and our tanks. So we worship all of that. Yeah. And it is all the presence of God. When she kept saying there is a God, I was compelled to ask a question. So do you know where is God? Where is God? If there is God, where do you find? So that answer, I think, would not be there when I would ask. Because the knowledge is half-baked yet. But I like the song, the optimism of it all, that there is presence of God. It's just about you feeling it. Maybe one day it will strike you. At some particular moment it will strike you, like the cancer thing, that you know, you're cured. Maybe you were not supposed to and it was a miracle. So you realize, oh, there was God's hand in it. Maybe
yeah, but then, you can't really blame God for the cures or the deaths when it comes to diseases such as cancer. I mean, what, over a million or so people succumb to cancer? In certain countries, just few countries, and over a million people die of cancer each year.
Mm-hmm.
Another million or two die of Alzheimer's each year all over the world, specifically in US of A. Those two are the main killers, even higher than COVID, if I'm not mistaken, in many ways. I mean, if you look at the overall stats, it definitely is more dead. And that's the presence of God for you. You can listen to it. If you can turn up your volume, presence of God, our neighbors, our neighborhood, it's all around us. I just, you can't really attribute God to deaths and miracles and cures and all that, because so many people die of those diseases. So you can't say, oh, because these people died, God isn't there.
Mm.
You know, that's the easiest thing for an American to say. You know, you often hear Americans talk so stupidly. You know, so it has nothing to do with God. Whether you're cured or not, you don't have to attribute the or blame it on God. God, for me, it's you know, an entity. It's like, you know, whatever I have in my life, and it may be very little if you compare it to lots of people around me and in the West. I have very little, you know, but whatever I have, whether it's a family, whether it's love, whether it's assets, you know, whatever assets I own or have the luxury of using, I think that is, I'm just grateful for having them, you know, and I only can thank God for it. You know, there's no one else that has possibly given it to me all those wonderful things, I mean, especially the intangible things when it comes to love, happiness, all those things, I can't attribute it to a particular TV show, a particular movie, a particular, you know, company or its products and services, no. The only thing, only person I can think of is God. So for me, God is someone that has shaped me and my lifestyle. And I'm very, very grateful for God's presence in my life, and I'm very, very thankful. You know, a lot of people have so much. I look at the Americans, I look at the English people, I look at a lot of people in my own country, and they have so much, you know. But they're always pissed off. They're always stressed out. They're always worried. They're always hating each other. You know, I mean, so that really... I always want to get into their head and understand why they are so crippled with hatred and animosity and greed and stress and worry and fear. One of the biggest things that cripples Americans today and countries like that who people are crippled by something is fear. You know, I mean, why are you so scared of others? You know, why are you so scared? And most of the people who pray in that part of the world, they usually pray for things that they are scared of happening to them. They're not thanking God enough. You know, you should spend more time being grateful than being an ungrateful BITCH or ASS.
Nice. So God is there.
That's it for this one.
I like your idea. Oh God, thank you.